That's my Lord Allah, the creator of us all.
Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, hamdan yuafi ni'amah wa yukafi'u mazida. سبحانك اللهم لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثليت على نفسك اللهم صل وسلم مبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ثم ما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters and respected elders, first of all, before I proceed, I would like to mention one very important thing. I have been receiving many complaints from the sister side regarding the gossip and regarding the conversation that take place in sister section. Many sisters, those who come to listen to khutbah and classes, they fail to listen because of too much noise in the sister section. I would like to request humbly, sisters, when you come to the house of Allah, please remain silent and let others benefit from the classes and from the khutbah and sermons. Jazakumullahu khairan. I would like to counsel myself and every one of you here to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, fear Allah and keep your duty to Him. And let every person look to what he has sent for tomorrow and fear Allah. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all aware of what you do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. And whosoever fears Allah and keeps his duty to Him, He will make a way for him to get out. So if from every difficulty. So if we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ease our difficulties. Imam Hassan al-Basri, radiallahu rahimahullah, he defined the God consciousness or taqwa by saying that at-taqwa hiya an tu'addi ma lillahi alayk, that you should be dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should fulfill the rights of Allah, as well as you must be fulfilling the rights of human being. So if somebody just observing the rights of Allah, this is not sufficient. We have to be dutiful and we have to fulfill the rights of human being as well. Now, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, previously we have discussed about our migration to the West and our residence in these countries. And we have agreed that we came to this country and we have lived and we resided and we took the citizenship with the hukum and with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And many of us, we never think of going back to our own countries where we came from. So hence we decided to stay in the West, and especially in Britain. We need to understand and we need to learn our roles and responsibilities in this country. First of all, as a Muslim, wherever we go, we should be practicing our religion. We should be fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And more importantly, we should represent our religion. And as a result of this, we can see Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told Sahaba radiallahu anhum, ittaqillaha haythuma kunt, fear Allah wherever you are. And we can see the beautiful nasiha, counseling was given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to his ambassador Mu'adh ibn Jabal, when he was heading towards Yemen. He said that Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu said that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told me, Ya Mu'adh, usika bi taqwallah, I counsel you to fear Allah, wa sidqil hadith, and I request and I counsel you to be truthful, wa wafa'il ahd, and to be fulfilling your contracts, fulfilling your deeds and covenants, wa ada'il amana, and do not betray, fulfill the trust, and wa rahmatil yatim, be kind to the orphans, be kind to the weak people, wa hifdhil juwar, look after your neighbors, be kind to your neighbors, wa kadhmil ghayz, control your anger, wa leenil kalam, and also be lenient in your conversation, in your dealing and transaction with people, wa badri salam, spread salam, and so on and so on. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gave a range of advice and counseling to Mu'adh ibn Jabal while he was going to Yemen. That shows that wherever we go, we represent our religion. We are the ambassadors of our religion. Each and every single one of us here, we represent our religion. So anything that we do, it will reflect our religion. If we do good, our religion will be good. If we do bad, then our religion will be bad. So we have to be very careful what we do, especially when we are living in a Muslim minority country. Secondly, we have to engage ourselves in da'wah. especially in the British society, where there's a freedom of da'wah. We can give da'wah, peaceful da'wah, as much as we can. And this is still possible in this country, as opposed to many European countries. It's quite difficult to do da'wah. So we have good opportunity to dialogue, to talk to people, to spread our message, to engage ourselves in da'wah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Ud'u ila sabili rabbik," invite people to the way of your Lord, bil hikmah, with wisdom and good and beautiful speech, and dialogue with them in the excellent wajadilhum billati, in excellent manner. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. Who can be better in speech than the one who does righteous deeds, وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and he proclaims that I am from the Muslims. So we can understand that there is a very good, beautiful opportunity in this country to preach our religion. And as our scholar said, it is one of the most important duties of a Muslim living in the West to spread the message of Islam in the beautiful and peaceful manner. Now, a Muslim can be da'i, can do da'wah individually. He can do da'wah by himself, and he can do da'wah under projects, under Islamic centers like this center. So Muslims can spread the message in different forms. And also a Muslim can spread the da'wah ila Allah, can spread the message of Allah through beautiful speech, through writings, through the social media, through social work, you know, helping and welfare and charity work, and also through the just and fair politics, and also through the beautiful mu'amala, beautiful dealing and transaction with people. And the character of a Muslim is the best asset of da'wah. And we have seen that throughout the history, the Muslims have managed to spread the message of Islam across the world through their beautiful characteristic. And we see Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi said, إنما بعثت لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق. I have been sent in order to complete the beautiful characteristic. وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised his prophet by saying that you are established on the beautiful characteristic. Number three, we should engage ourselves in the West seeking knowledge as much as possible. Unfortunately, Muslims, we do not want to learn. We are very lazy. We do not want to learn. As soon as we go to A-levels, we just get a job in a supermarket, wherever. Alhamdulillah, all jobs are good. All jobs are praiseworthy. But Muslims should target to be in the highest position. And we should be targeting to be best in our education, whether it's Islamic education or it's the secular education, because our predecessors, they wouldn't differentiate between the Islamic education and secular education. They would learn all types of knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ. Say, those who know and those who do not know are the same, are they equal? Of course not, they can't be equal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. Seek, read in the name of your Lord, the first verse that ever was revealed. That's read in the name of your Lord who created you. So a Muslim should be targeting to be excellent in his education, in his college level, A-levels, degrees, in his master's, PhD, and he should target to be in the highest position as an engineer, as a doctor, as a scientist, as a teacher, as in every sector, wherever you are, try and be the best one. This is the responsibility of a Muslim. Number four, a Muslim should be presentable. A Muslim should be clean. A Muslim should be good looking, smart, you know, well fragrant, with good smell. We see, unfortunately, many of our Muslims today, we do not tend to take care of our look. We don't tend to take care of our appearance. But it's really, really important, especially when we're living in a society where these things really highly matter. I don't mean to say to buy the most expensive clothes, like branded clothes, because they are for commercial reasons. Rather, we should try and wear the best clothes and the beautiful clothes that we have, and we should be looking good and presentable. If somebody doesn't like you to come next to you, then how can you spread your message, and how can you invite people to your religion? So it's very important for us to be looking good and spelling well. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna Allah jamil wa yuhibbul jamal." Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beautiful and He loves the beauty. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he loved the fragrance the most, and he was one of the people that if you would go pass by in the morning, then the smell of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would still be there even in the afternoon. And also, we should be smiling. We forget to smile. We forgot actually Muslims to smile. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La tahqiranna min al-ma'rufi shay'a." Do not belittle anything in my religion, even if it's meant to be smiling at your Muslim brother or fellow human being. So it's very important for us to be smiling. A gloomy person, we can't be attractive. We can't be influential. Unfortunately, as for Muslims today, we became influenced, not influential. In order to be influential, we have to make sure that our appearance is good. Many of us even come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our socks are in incorrect position, incorrect condition, our appearance is not in correct condition. We have to make sure that we beautify ourselves, but for Allah and for Islam, not for anything else. Very, very important. And also number five, that we should be productive Muslim. Wherever we are, we should be productive, not destructive. We should be a contributors towards the economy and towards the civilization of the country that we live, because we have decided that we're going to be living here. So we have to be productive. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us to be productive wherever we are. Also, we have to be very careful with our neighbors and people around us in our workplace, in schools, in universities, wherever we have to make sure that we are good people, and so that people don't get a bad impression about Islam. So be good to your neighbors. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave a high importance in looking after the neighbors. And lastly, we should respect the system and laws of the country, especially if the laws are made for the benefit of us as citizens. So we have to be very careful what we do. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to practice upon what has been said. If I've said anything right, it's from Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If I've said anything wrong, then it's from me and from shaytan. And I apologize if I have offended anybody. Wa jazakum Allah khair. Allahumma kullana wa la takun alayna. Allahumma alif bayna qulubina. Wa aslih dhata baynina. Allahumma anfa' Allahumma مهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم اعز اسلامنا وانصر المسلمين واهد الناس اجمعين اللهم زد حبك وحب نبيك في قلوبنا اللهم وحد صفوفنا واجمع كلمتنا يا اله الكون يا رب العالمين واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين وارض اللهم عن جميع صحابه رضوان الله عليهم اجمعين خاصه ابي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي والحسن والحسين وجميع صحابة رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين وعنا معهم بمنك وكرمك وجودك يا إله الكون يا رب العالمين أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وأقم الصلاة